Okay, so the last part will be the table output that we already did, and I want to show you the full scale and to wrap it up just to sum what we did so far. So basically we take the table output and we generate it from this transformation a table with the data of date key, date in, years, date and months. Now I want to delete, I will delete all the data inside this dim date. Okay, truncate the table. So now we don't have any data. I will refresh and there's no data. Okay, and I will go to our ETL part at the dim date and I will just run it. Okay, I can launch it. I have parameters and arguments, and as I said, if you have something like variables, then you can manually put them here if they don't coming, they're not coming straight away. And we launch it. He asks us to save, and we save. So now you will see here the actual all the steps and how many lines read and written. So how many getting in, how many is getting out, and you can see that this output of the table output is actually the amount of rows that getting into our table output. So we generated rows, actually 7,300 of them, with the fixed value of all of them of the date. Then we add 1, 2, 3 sequence to another column, a new column. I will show it. Okay, and now you can see we have column of a date and column of sequence. Now we are going to add them up, so we will have another column with date. Okay, so in the calculator what we did is we take a date and actually take the first column plus the second column, date in plus value name. And of course we take the year, months and date from the outcome of the dates. So this was the third one. After that we had too many columns, because when we generated the rows we still have the dates. I will do it the first one, the calculator. Okay, so I open the calculator, I have the date in and value, because nothing can make them go away, but we just need those four, the date, the year, the months and the day. So we needed another step that will delete the two columns, the two extra columns. So now they are gone, because when we clicked and opened the select values, you can see that where there is remove we pick them both. So for now we can okay, and we cancel. Then we wanted to add up and make the key of the date by removing the hyphens, and we did it in the longest way we can, okay, by mapping. Okay, so we mapped here, we went to this phase, this transformation, actually did the select values, string cut, concat the fields, okay, and then got the data right back to the same component, the sub, the mapping. After that we use the string operation in order to fix a little bit our data types and trims, and fix the strings. Then we pick the select values step in order to create the data types and the lengths and the format of the years, and after that we threw it to a table. Now I want to play it again, and it will be very fast. What you need to understand is that those are all the steps that we have here. Okay, every step here is we have a step, and we have an input and output, from what you read, what you written, and if it's an input or output, and if we have rejects or not. We will see rejects later, but if we have errors or stuff like that, we can handle the error, but we can see that we have errors and how many do we had. What you can see that the generate rows, because it's in memory, it generates 912,500 rows per 1 second. Okay, this is a very very fast step. That is because it's in memory. The second one is also fast, but he ran very quickly to generate the sequence. Okay, and you can see how much time it took. Now the table output is the most consuming. When I play, and we can see it, I will play the sequence. You can see that this one, everything is already ended. You can see finish, and in the running you get that 1,000 rows in a second. Okay, so because we have 7,300 rows, it took 10 seconds the whole process. Okay, so this is what we see here, and that's it about the dim date.